Hey girlies, it's Tammi. Welcome back to my channel. So today my neighbor has decided to mow their lawn and I don't know if you guys can hear it, but I'm running on time here, so I need to film this now. So if you can hear the lawn mower, I'm sorry about that, but there's nothing I can do. I can't, you know, run outside and shout, "Stop doing that!" I wish I could, but I can't. Anyways, today's video is all about the new iHeart Revolution mini chocolate palette. So I have all four of them here. There is orange, rose gold, mint, and nude chocolate. So these are the mini versions. I do also have the bigger versions here so I can show you like comparisons if they have the same shades in them or not. So what I'm gonna do first is go through one by one, show you the inside of the bigger palette as well. And then I'm gonna pick one to do a tutorial on my eyes with today, kind of like what I did with the egg video. So let's just get started. So the first one right in front of me is chocolate orange. So this is what the packaging looks like. When you open it up, this is the inside of the chocolate palette. So this is the size of it. So let me show you compared. Actually, let me open this one too. That would help. So I hope you guys can see it's kind of like half the size of it. And the big ones retail for £8.99 and the small ones retail for £6, I think. £6 or £6.99, one of them. And it is about half the size. So I suppose the better value is with the bigger palette, but if you are looking for a travel friendly size, I suppose these would be very good palettes for traveling. So they are cruelty free and vegan. So this is what the inside of the mini chocolate orange looks like. I absolutely love that you do get a deep dark brown in here because, you know, I love to deepen up that outer V. You get two shimmery colors and then six matte. So the smaller pans are matte shades and the bigger pans are shimmery shades. I really like the color selection in this palette. It's warm tone. I mean, if I was traveling, this would be a great palette because I know warm tone suits my eyes really, really well. So I think this palette would just be gorgeous. You could put this color all over your lid as well as the inner corner. Nice warm colors in the crease, and that is a perfect everyday look. So this palette is definitely very practical for my skin tone and what I like to go for on an everyday basis. Oh, that was a long sentence. And then here we have them side by side. So I mean, there are similar colors in terms of being warm tone. So of course you get an orange in both palettes. You kind of get this burgundy color as well in both palettes. You get the dark chocolatey brown in both palettes. Overall, you would get very similar looks from both palettes, but of course you can create more looks with the bigger palette because you have more shades. I don't personally think you need both. So if you do have the big one, there's no real point going for the small one unless you want to travel. If you are going on holiday this summer or whatever and you love the shades in here, this would be a good alternative because this packaging is quite bulky and heavy to travel with. And then next we have the rose gold shade. Now this once again is different from its bigger counterpart. This one is more of a rose gold shade, and then this one is more golden. I don't really see the rose in this packaging. I mean, there's a slight sheen of pink rose color, but okay, yeah, it's definitely a rose goldy color as you can see, but definitely not as intense as the bigger packaging. Let me take this one out of the packaging. I should have just took them all out of the boxes. Okay, so I hope you guys can see the difference in the color packaging, but also the mini one comes in white packaging whereas the big one comes in like a chocolatey brown packaging. So let's go ahead and open the small rose gold one up. And this is what it looks like on the inside. Very neutral, kind of berry purpley tones, but I absolutely love the shimmers in here. This is kind of like a rose gold color, which is absolutely stunning. The transitions look really nice. This would be my favorite color out of this palette because I love berry tones and, you know, all of that in the crease. Now when it's compared to its bigger counterpart, so I'm gonna compare it to, okay, let's try that again. Oh my god, so here we have them compared, the big rose gold palette compared to the smaller one. And to me overall, I mean, the transition brownie colors are very similar, but overall the feel of the palette, they're not similar in my opinion. I don't feel like you could probably get a very similar look out of the palette because of that berry burgundy tone once again, but I feel like they are different enough to have both if you wanted to get both. Okay, so next we're moving on to Choc Mint, which is the mint one. Of course it comes with the green packaging. Now this one has an ombre on it, which is super cool. And then here we have the inside of the mint chocolate one. So as you can see, it is a full neutral palette with that one pop of green. green, which they probably intended to put on your lower lash line as like a pop of color. But overall, it's very neutral. You get neutral browns in here, you get neutral shimmery champagne and gold shades to put on your lid, and then you get that one pop of green, which is where I suppose the mint comes in. It looks like a very nice neutral palette. Once again, guys, very travel friendly, overall very neutral, but you do get that one pop of color. I'm not mad at the colors inside of the palette, but if you guys know my style of makeup, you know I like colorful palettes, and I like palettes that have a bit of, you know, variety in them. I'm not here for straight neutral palettes, and that's just of course personal preference, but I definitely see the vision behind these palettes in terms of if I was traveling, you know, this palette would be perfect because it's, you know, got the neutral colors. When I'm traveling, I'm not really looking for bright out there, all of that, because you just, most of the time you're going out exploring, you don't want to be like faffing around with your eyeshadow and stuff. So these are very practical palettes for travel, like I said. But just as palettes, like as a makeup lover, they're just not inspiring palettes. But like I said, I see the vision behind it, so don't come for me. I know they're travel palettes, I get it. Okay, so here we have both of the mint choc palettes. So this is the bigger one, of course. It comes with more variety in terms of colorful shades. It does have neutral shades as well, like over here. So with the bigger palette, you can definitely get neutral looks as well as colorful looks. But yeah, there we are compared. So once again, they are very different palettes in my opinion. The only similar color is of course the matte green, but apart from that, they are very, very different, like vibes. I'm getting different vibes from them. And then last but not least, guys, we have the nudes palette, which looks like this. So of course the big nudes palette is a new release from Revolution, and then they've also done a small mini version of it. Okay, so here we have the inside of the nudes mini palette, and as you can see, probably the name gives it away, it's a nude palette. Most of this palette is shimmery. It does come with 1, 2, 3 matte colors, and then it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shimmery colors. So I think, yeah, this palette has the most shimmers out of all of them. The rose gold has 2 shimmers, the chocolate orange has 2 shimmers, the mint choc has 4 shimmers, and then this one has 5 shimmers. So the nudes definitely has the most shimmers out of all of them. And once again, guys, very travel friendly, very neutral palette. This palette kind of reminds me of like Gigi Hadid. I don't know, I just caught a glimpse of it and I was just like, this kind of looks like the Gigi Hadid palette. The neutral browns that are actually in here seem to be very decent like colors. They seem to be deep enough to show up on my skin tone, which is great. You also get this peachy transition color. So overall, it's a very nice palette if you do like neutral tones, but just not for me. And then here we have the brand new palette from iHeartRevolution. This is called the Nudes Chocolate Palette. I actually haven't tried this on my eyes yet. I'm gonna film a video for Revolution using this palette next week, so definitely follow their YouTube channel if you want to see me using this palette. So the difference between this palette and every other chocolate bar palette is the names are actually printed onto the palette. The rest of them have the plastic sheet. So here we have the nudes palette, and of course it's very neutral. This looks very, very nice actually. Now that I'm giving it a nice close-up look, it looks like it has those gorgeous warm transition colors. You also get deep browns in here, you get this deep purple. Is that matte or is that shimmery? Because I can't really tell at this angle. It seems to be like a satin finish, but more on the matte side. This would be gorgeous on the outer V actually. This palette has potential, guys. Of course, not my favorite because I'm not a fan of like all natural palettes, but it has potential to create some really nice neutral looks. Okay, and then here we have the two nude palettes side by side. So I feel like because of course it's a neutral nude palette, it's hard to kind of get different shades in both. They have very similar shades to each other. I really want to go in with the chocolate orange palette because I feel like out of all of them, this is the one that talks to me the most in terms of shade. It has fun summer spring shades in there, and it also has that deep dark brown, which I would love to use in the outer V. So I feel like I'm gonna go for this one today. So now that I've told you my thoughts on the color selection in each palette, now we're gonna test the formula. I expect them to be good because Revolution eyeshadows are really good quality, especially for the price. But I'm quickly gonna prime my eyes using the Revolution Conceal and Define in C11. I'm just gonna put a little bit of that on my lid, and I'm just gonna use my foundation brush to tap that in. And I'm also gonna set my eyelids using a little bit of Sasha Buttercup Light Powder, just the smallest amount to just set that area. So they don't have eyeshadow names, of course, so I'm just gonna dip into this peachy color here and also the orange. I'm gonna mix the two. I love mixing eyeshadows, and I'm gonna put that straight into the crease area. By the way, I always get asked what brushes I'm using. This is the Morphe E22 brush. I love the e-brushes from their eyeshadow brush line. Yeah, just as I expected, very good pigmentation. I mean, it's revolution. I didn't expect anything else. It's showing up beautifully, blending out beautifully. I have no complaints. And I actually really like holding this in my hands. You know when it's just small and mini and you're just like, I don't know, I'm weird. I like that. I think I'm also gonna take a dab of this kind of berry color right here, and I'm gonna put that into the crease as well. I'm kind of just experimenting. I wanna see what the shades look like. Okay, so this one's kind of got like a reddish berry undertone to it. So now I'm going to take a little bit more of a precise brush, and this is the E17, and I'm going to dip into the deeper, darker brown shade, which seems to be really pigmented, so I'm hoping it comes across pigmented on the eyes. And I'm going to start blending that, whoa, very pigmented, on the inner and outer corner to kind of start that halo eye off. I can barely see what I'm doing, guys. I'm so far from my mirror. Okay, that color seems to be deep and dark enough. It's adding nice darkness, definitely showing up. It's blending really well with the other colors. Okay, then back in with my previous brush and a dab of the first colors that I used just to diffuse that crease area. Make sure it's all blended. So now I'm gonna pick a shimmer for the, what's this called? The center of the eyelid, and I think I'm gonna go with the gold because the pink, I don't know why, but the pink doesn't really go with the warm tone colors in my opinion. It just looks so cold and lonely sitting there by itself. I don't know, maybe if you use these four together you might get a cute, sorry my camera stopped recording, but for the look that I've done, I feel like this is just too cold for what I like to go for. Like, do you guys see that color? I don't know. It might go. You never know till you put it on the eyes, I suppose. Okay, do you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna try it. We're gonna try it, and then we're gonna top it with the gold to, you know, add that goldenness to it. But I'm gonna start with the pink, and we're gonna see. You see how cold it is? It's just a very cool tone eyeshadow, cool tone pink eyeshadow. So I'm just tapping that on. Oh, I should have put a bit of concealer to make it pop even more, but it looks okay, it's popping, very pigmented. She's gone very far. I don't know, guys, do you think it goes? I think because of the cool tone brown, it goes. Do you know what I mean? I mean, the shade itself is beautiful. I just don't know if I like it in the palette. This is the type of color that I would put with like purples and stuff because it's so cool tone. It would just complement purple. But the eye look still looks good, so I mean, you decide. So I'm gonna take a dab of that gold shade as well, and I'm just gonna top it. That gold is pigmented. Wow. This gold is stunning and very pigmented. Okay, so overall, I definitely feel like the eyeshadows are up to Revolution's normal standards. They blend really well. They show up beautifully on the eyes. I'm gonna go complete the rest of my face so I look a bit more put together, and then I'll come back with my final review on this palette, and I'll show you guys my final look as well. So I'll be right back. Okay, guys, and I'm back. So here we have the final look. I've turned my two soft boxes off so you guys can see like the true color of the eyeshadow. So I really like the final look. This is a really cute everyday look. I'm a bit dramatic, a bit everyday glam look, but overall I really like these palettes, guys. Of course the quality is definitely there, so like I always say, if you find a shade selection that you know you're gonna love and use all the time, they're definitely worth the £6 in my opinion. However, of course, like I did say earlier, you do get better value by buying the bigger palettes. You get more for your money, I suppose. So overall, guys, if you are traveling this year, or you know, travel regularly for your job or something, these are definitely very handy palettes. They definitely pack a punch in terms of pigmentation, and they are really small. As you can see, they're like the size of my hand or palm. They're really good to travel with, like I said. But if you don't travel that much, I mean, the bigger palettes are better value, and they're kind of the same thing. You would get like a similar look. They're not the exact same shades, but you would get a similar look from the bigger palette. So if you're always at home 24/7 like me, then definitely go with the bigger palettes because you get more selection for your your money, or you could just get them because they're super cute and they're like mini chocolate. I don't know, it's up to you guys. I'm just here to give you my thoughts and opinions on it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'll catch you guys in my next one. Take care, bye.